सो हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम विहान एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक विच यू शुड ऑलवेज नो एंड द नेम ऑफ दिस टॉपिक इज इंडियन एंड वेस्टर्न कल्चर. देयर आर मैनी पीपल हु हैव कन्फ्यूजन बिटवीन दीज टू टॉपिक्स, सो आई एम गोइंग टू टेल एंड देयर आर मैनी डिबेटेबल थिंग्स विच आई विल नॉट डू. यू कैन कंक्लूड बाई योर सेल्फ. ओके, सो इफ आई बिगेन, सो फर्स्ट थिंग कम्स दैट इज न्यूडिटी, मीन्स नग्नता. So in Western culture, nudity is very common, but in Indian culture, it is not common. It is there in some big cities like Delhi, Mumbai, but not everywhere. Yeah, so we can say that if a Indian culture people will see these things, so he will be strange. So these things are strange to him. Suppose you are in Goa in a beach, and suddenly you saw a girl, and she is sleeping by wearing two-piece clothes. So you will think that how is she comfortable here? But it is common in Western culture. In Western culture, in every beach, you can see that many girls are sleeping by wearing two-piece clothes because they want to take sun bath. And to take sun bath, many foreigners come in India also and they wear two-piece. So I want to say that it is common in Western culture. But if you will see it, if you are a people of Indian culture, so it will be strange to you. And the next thing is prostitution. And brothels and prostitute. So prostitute means Vaishya and brothel means where they live. So if I talk about India or Indian culture, so in India there are few brothels. Okay, if I say there are many brothels, so there can be, but suppose you live in an apartment on first floor and suddenly a person comes to you and he says that, suppose you are a man, so he will say that, sir, can I know where is the brothel? And suppose you say that it is on second floor, and after some time he comes and he says to you, thank you for telling me. So how will you feel? And suppose in your colony, suppose if there is a brothel, okay, so it might be the case that you register a case in police station, because in India it is very strange, and according to Indian, these works are very bad. Okay, but in Western culture it is common. As I gave you the example of, suppose there is a person and he will ask to you for the brothel, so it is very common there. And even there person can say where is the studio, because in Western culture brothels are called studios. So he will not say that brothel, he will say that studio, but not every time, because sometime he can also say brothel. It is not, means most of the time they will say studio. So the next point which I want to say is kissing or smooching. So these both things are very common in Western culture, but not in Indian culture. Suppose you are going in the road, okay, and suddenly you saw a couple by hugging each other. So it will be very strange to you. But think there, even the person are ready to kiss or smooch each other even in the public place. So you can think that if you will say that it is the development of mentality, so it is fine. But if you will say that they are shameless, so according to me it is not there, because it is the development of mentality. So my next point is cleanliness. Suppose you are going in a railway station, so it might be the case that you see that there is a lot of garbage and people are just throwing the bottles in the railway station or railway track. But it is not there in Western culture, because in Western culture all the railway station and all the cities are very clean. Suppose you are a tourist, okay, and you go to suppose America and you throw a bottle in the road, not in the dustbin, so a person can even come to beat you, because their cleanliness is very prevalent. They are the thing that if country will not be clean, so even our mentality will not be clean. In Indian culture people think only their house is their house, but in Western culture people think their city and whole country as their house. That's why there is lot of cleanliness there. And if you will throw garbage, so even they can register a case upon you or an FIR. And the next point is kids get separated after 20 or 18. Yeah, it is not prevalent, but most of the time, suppose in 100, suppose 99.9% times, the child will get separate after 20 or 22 or 18. And they will live in any apartment on rent, or they will buy it, because they don't want to be a burden on their parents, because they think that if we will live whole life with their parents, so privacy is also there, okay, because parents have also their privacy and kids have also their privacy. So that's why they live in a different apartment or in a different house. एंड माई नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज अपॉइंटमेंट. सपोज इन इंडिया इवन द रिलेटिव्स कम सडनली एंड दे विल सपोज दे आर इन द रोड एंड दे विल से दैट इन 5 मिनट्स आई एम कमिंग टू योर हाउस. सो इट इज़ वेरी बैड थिंग. बट इन इवन इन वेस्टर्न कल्चर सपोज योर फादर इज कमिंग टू योर हाउस सो इवन ही विल कॉल यू एंड देन ही विल से दैट एट वॉट टाइम शुड आई कम. ओके सपोज इट इज वेडनेसडे एंड यू से दैट फादर यू कैन कम ऑन मंडे सो ही विल वेट फॉर मंडे एंड सपोज यू सेट 3 o'clock सो ही विल कम बिफोर 3 o'clock सपोज ऑन 2:55 PM because their timings are very prevalent and the people are disciplined. They think that if I will come without asking to my child, so it might be the case that he will be disturbed. So that's why there all the people are very disciplined and country is also very clean. And my next point is small kids or small girls or boys sleep in different room. In India, you might have seen that the kids of 18 or 20 years old, even they are sleeping with their parents. But in a Western culture, suppose after 6 or 7, when the kids get mature and he can take care of himself, then they make another room or they shift him in another room and then he will sleep alone or with a sister or brothers. Because in Western culture, people think that if he will sleep with me only, so he will not be self-dependent. So in Western culture, this thing is very prevalent. Or in such movies, you have also seen that the child are sleeping with, not sorry, childs are not sleeping with their parents. They are children are not sleeping with their parents. They are sleeping alone or with their siblings. And my next point is gynecologist. In India, you have such time you have seen that girls shy or they feel uncomfortable. Girls are shy and they feel uncomfortable by if they will go to male gynecologist. Okay, but in Western culture it is very very common. Okay, suppose there are two hospitals or there are two clinics. Okay, first clinic is 5 kilometers far and second is 12 kilometers far. Okay, suppose in first clinic which is 5 kilometers far, in that a male gynecologist is there and in second one a female is there. Okay, so in Western culture, girls will think that what is the need to waste my time? I will go to the clinic in which male gynecologist is there, okay? Because they are not shy. And it is upon you whether you think it the development of mentality or you think this is stupidity. It's upon you, okay? And if I come on the next point. So the next point is smoking and drinking is prevalent there. Suppose in Western culture, you can see that even suppose students are drinking with their parents, okay? Suppose a child is there and he is in 10th class and he comes back to his home and then he is smoking and his mother is saying that, do you want a shot also? So it's very common there. In some movies you can also see this thing, okay? So it's upon you because alcohol and smoking is injurious to health. So it's upon you if it is a debatable topic. And if I come on the next point, so the next point is awareness. Awareness about law is there. Suppose there you do a crime, okay? Suppose you have the gun, even the person can call police. Suppose in front of him a murder is going on and he can call the police. But in India, so sometimes you have seen that, suppose you say that in a neighborhood smuggling is going on. So your parents can say to you that what is the need to poke our nose in this matter? Because suppose he runs away from jail, so he can come to kill us. So police will do the thing and anyone else can complain, please sit in the home, otherwise I will not send you out of the home. But their awareness of law is there. Suppose even a 5-year-old child complains to his parents, so they will say that call to police, okay? Because they think that if our country will be destroyed, corruption will be there, so how will we get development? So they think about their country and ourselves also, okay? But in India, people think only about ourselves, not for country. And in India, corruption is also there. But in Western culture, if corruption will be there, so it will be very high. But not for only 400 to 500 rupees, okay? In India, corruption is there for small things also. But in Western culture, या तो वो होगी ही नहीं या फिर होगी तो बहुत बड़ी चीज़ों के लिए ही होगी. इट विल बी नेग्लिजिबल और इट विल बी इन वेरी हाई अमाउंट. ओके एंड नेक्स्ट थिंग आई वॉन्ट टू टॉक अबाउट इज स्ट्रिक्ट लॉज एंड रूल्स. ओके इन वेस्टर्न कल्चर वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट रूल्स आर देयर. सपोज देयर इज अ रोड, ओके, एंड इन विच नो पार्किंग इज रिटन, सो नो वन विल पार्क हिज और हर कार. okay, and fine is also very high there. But in Indian culture, you have seen that suppose there is written no parking in front of a house, still there is a car, okay. And in India, sometimes police officers also get corrupted, okay. So next point which I want to talk about is tax is also very high in Western culture. It is also very high in Indian culture also, but sometimes people take the path of corruption and they make excuses in giving tax. But in Western culture, people like to give tax and they love to give tax to the government. Even they give 50 to 55% of their income to the government. So government also do many things for people in Western culture. Government distributes free food and there are many facilities also for poor people and who are unemployed, okay. But in Indian culture, nothing is like this. And my next point is, humility is there, but by the name of racism. In India, you have heard about reservation, which took birth because of casteism, okay. But in Western culture, racism is there, okay. And it is because of body color. Suppose there is a person and his body tone is very black, okay. So people will start humiliating him. But in Western culture, there is a rule. Suppose there is any organization, suppose there is a theater or suppose there is a hotel. Suppose there is a hotel, so there should be one member who is black. Otherwise, law will be there and the hotel's manager or the hotel's owner have to pay fine. It is the rule there and we can say the reservation also. So according to me, it is good. And if I come on the next point, so my next point is duplicate items are not sold there. Sometimes it might be the case that it is negligible, but most of the time 100% real products are sold there. It might be the case that 1% is not real, but in India like this you have seen that Chor Bazaar is there, okay, in which
gray market
is there and in which all the duplicate and the stolen items sold. But suppose someone saw the gray market in Western culture, so he can complain to the police and he will say that the stolen item are sold here and I want a police here, okay. So it might be the case that if you open a market like this in Western culture, so you will be caught very soon. And my next point is love marriage, arrange marriage and live in relationship. In Western culture, love marriage is very prevalent and in Western culture, arrange marriage is not there. 100% love marriage is there, okay. Suppose you say to a person of Western culture that in India arranged marriage is there, so he will be shocked, okay. Then he will think that how can we get married with a boy or girl whom we even don't know. Then he will say that love marriage is better. And in Western culture, only love marriages are there. Suppose you say to your parents that I love a girl and I want to do love marriage, so it might be the case that your parents will scold you and they will beat you. And they will say that you will do only arranged marriage. And in India, it is because of society. Because someone will do love marriage, so society can humiliate him or her. So that's why in India, arranged marriages are there and sometimes love marriages are there. But in Western culture, every time, not even a single chance can be there in which arranged marriage is there. All the time, arranged marriage is not there, only love marriage are there. And if I talk about living relationship, so as I said that after 18 or 22, the child will get separate. So there, suppose they live in an apartment. So there they can live with their girlfriend or boyfriend. And suppose his father or mother comes to meet him or her. Suppose he introduce his father with his new girlfriend, okay. So father will say that, okay, you have such a nice girlfriend. He will not beat him. But suppose in Indian culture, you have a girlfriend and even you say to your father, okay. So it might be the case that he will beat you. But in Western culture, it is not there. Because the parents think that if child is happy, so we are also happy. And there is no need to worry about society because in Western culture, development of mind is there, according to me. And the next point is divorce is very common in Western culture. Suppose in Indian culture, someone gets divorced, okay? So it might be the case that you will be very sad. But in Western culture, most of the time, divorce are there because suppose wife is not good or husband is not good. Suppose you say to a Western culture girl, okay, that... Suppose a Western culture girl says to you that I got divorced. So you will be very sad, okay. But he will or she will say to you that why are you being sad? I am very happy because my rascal husband is not there with me now, okay. So reason is there, that's why she is happy. And my next point is lavish marriages are not there. Marriages are cheaper. suppose in India you have seen that lavish marriages are there, okay? In dowry, suppose groom's family is getting Mercedes or Fortuner, okay? But in Western culture, arranged marriage is not there and dowry system is not there also. Okay, and in India, dowry system is banned by the government, but still people take and people give also. And according to me, it is bad if there is a force on bribes family. And if I talk about the Western culture, so in which dowry system is not there, and even both the families give 50-50 amount of the marriage, okay? Suppose in Indian culture, you have seen that, suppose a marriage is taking place, okay? So most of the time, it is the case that bribes family is meeting the expenses of the marriage, okay? But in Western culture, groom's family and bride's family give 50-50 amount. Because according to them, no one is smaller, all are equal, okay? And nowadays in India, dowry system is in peak, okay? All the people are taking dowry and they will not say that I want to take dowry. They will just ask that what is your budget? And suppose that it is not cheaper, it is expensive, so they will marry. And suppose the budget is cheaper, so they will not marry. And that's why, according to me, arranged marriage is not better than love marriage. And if I talk about the next point, so the next point is people get 50-50, okay? Sorry, people get marriage at the age of 50, 55 and 60 or 65. But in India, it is not there. Suppose someone thinks to get married at 50 or 55 age. So his family member will say that, now how will you get married? No girl is there of 50 to 55 age. Okay, but in Western culture, as I said that the divorce is very common. If divorce is very common, so the girls of or the boys of age 50 to 55 will be definitely there. So that's why sometimes, suppose your friend is a foreigner, okay? So sometimes he can say to you that I want to invite you in my suppose second father, means understood by second father, and he is of 65 age and he is getting married with a girl. So you will be shocked, but there it is very common. And I want to tell you a thing, that in Western culture, only limited people are invited in the marriage. Suppose in Indian culture, you have seen that, suppose your friends are invited also. But in Western culture, only limited people are invited, like first family and second family, okay? And they think that if we will invite more people, so lavish marriage will be there. And because they have also a limited budget, so even they invite their near and dear people, which they have a very good relation with. And if I talk about the next point, so that's conclusion. So according to me, both the cultures are good. And if I talk about some advantages and disadvantages, so some disadvantages in Western culture, according to me, there is some advantages and disadvantages. Suppose in Western culture, people smoke and drink with their parents. So according to me, it is bad because it is injurious to health. And if I talk about Indian culture, so in Indian culture, arranged marriage is there and love marriage is not allowed by the side of parents. Dowry system is there. And sometimes people are afraid of law. Okay, they will think that if I will complain this person, so it might be the case after some time, after get freeing from jail, he can kill me, okay? And in both the cultures, superstitions are there, so I am not counting it as a difference. But the difference is there, suppose in Indian culture, same superstition is there, but by the name of different things. And in Western culture, superstitions are there, but by the name of different things. So thank you for listening my presentation.